It's time for Reason.
They have really abused their power, saying, well, we're not going to tell you exactly how much money they used to. This is how much money we need to see for it to be, quote unquote, suitable. And that way you're constitutionally compliant. Nowadays, they say, yeah, you know what? We made a mistake back then. We're not allowed to tell you exactly how much because you do have the power of the purse, but only to some degree because we still get to tell you whether it's constitutional or not. So I can't tell you how much, but you need more money.
This is the Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier. Then I'll get on my knees and pray.
We don't get fooled again. Don't get fooled again. Oh, welcome into the Voice of Reason right here on the Mid-America Network. The day that we've been looking forward to after an entire holiday weekend last week. The extended work week this week, I know a lot of people had a lot of trouble trying to get through it, but guess what? You made it, baby. Welcome into it. Good morning to you. It's an honor to have you along. This is The Voice of Reason. I am Andy Hoosier, and welcome aboard. 316-721-8255, 316-721-TALK. If you want to join in, it is a Friday. Whatever's on your mind, whatever's troubling you today, it's open lines to you. Anything you want to talk about, because that's just how we roll on a Friday morning. Let's do it. Come on. Make it happen. All right. 316-721-8255, 316-721-TALK. If you want to join in on the phone line, shoot me a message on Facebook if you want to as well. On the Voice Reason page, the KQAM page, the Twitter at Hoosier Reason. The Facebook Live feed is up and rolling as well, rolling on all of these stations that we broadcast on for the first hour here on KIUL, on KYUL, on KGYN, and of course on KQAM here in the Wichita area. Got a lot to get to today. As you know, the tax vote in the Senate, as they were planning on voting on it sometime yesterday afternoon. They did not vote on it yesterday afternoon. Ended up voting, they're planning on voting on it supposedly today at 11 o'clock. Now, I have been encouraging everybody to reach out to their elected officials, their senators, to make sure that they vote for this daggone thing. And they're manipulating it, they're twisting it, they're trying to change it left and right. They are desperate to make this bill fail. And we talked about this yesterday. I don't want to go too much into it again. But as you know, the predominant supposed senator from Tennessee, Bob Corker, has been very concerned about this bill. Well, we might have to raise the debt by $1.5 trillion because of these tax deductions and giving people more money in their pocket. It's a terrible travesty, and we shouldn't be allowing this to happen. So we need to have some kind of safeguard in that if we don't see the projections that we anticipate and we don't see and if we start seeing some kind of downfall, then we can have automatic tax increases again. Bring it back, baby. Bring it back. It's a good sound, isn't it? It's a good jive to know that if you don't start spending your money as opposed to paying off your debts and actually doing your own thing because it's your own damn money, then it doesn't matter. They're just going to start raising your taxes again. And that's what they want. They want to raise, they're worried about, is it going to generate enough economic growth to lower its $1.4 trillion revenue cost? But they only have been able to by squeezing it, by trying to anticipate the economic growth, by doing what they've been doing so far. They are anticipating only compensating for $458 billion over a decade. There's two sides to this, and we always have to remember this. And no matter what we do, cutting taxes, no matter what we do with increasing the economic growth and the GDP lowering the tax rates and increasing job growth and increasing opportunity and increasing the incentive for businesses and LLCs and corporations and individuals to want to stay here, no matter what we do, there's always another side to this. And if you want to try and compare it to the state of Kansas, if you want to try and compare it to the state of Oklahoma, then you need to learn the lesson. I mean, again, I'm going to reiterate that there is no comparison because the state governments are totally different than the federal government's budgets. But if you want to try and compare it, the one thing that we did not do in the state of Kansas is cut spending. We didn't cut spending. We borrowed. We had to move things around, but we did not cut spending. No matter what anybody tells you, and if they tell you otherwise, they're a liar. Liar. Because that's not what happened. We need to cut spending. We need to get our budget under control. And at the federal level, we have to do the same thing. Now, again, the budget, the debt ceiling is going to be coming up on December 8th, next Friday. They're going to vote to increase the debt ceiling again. I don't want to see it, but that's what's going to happen. And right now, that's a battle that I don't think we need to fight while we're trying to do tax reform. Once we get the tax reform done, let's address the budget. Let's address the debt ceiling. We put in an amendment saying that we'll never do it again. We start cutting some of our spending, and then we can start getting on a payment plan. Once we lower our costs, again, if you're an individual and you have more and more debts piling up and you don't see enough revenue and you're trying to find more revenue to compensate for this, and you're already working three jobs and your wife is already working a job or two themselves, or you're both working two jobs apiece, or whatever the case is, and you have capped yourself out on how much you can actually work, and your bosses obviously are not just going to give you a raise because you are in your own personal financial issues and financial troubles. It's not going to happen. So what are you going to do? The only thing you can do is start cutting your costs. You look at your budget. You consolidate. You realize that sometimes you cannot go out to dinner every night and spend $100 on a bottle of wine and some nice amenities, whatever it may be. Or you can't even go out to Taco Bell at times if you need to, because if you go out to dinner every single night, it's going to be very expensive for you as opposed to going home and having a bowl of cereal. And sometimes that's just what you have to do. Listen to Dave Ramsey. He'll tell you all about getting your personal finances under order. But you have to not only find the cap about what you can do for revenue, but you also have to cut the spending. And that's what the state of Kansas did. So if you want to learn any lesson at all from the state of Kansas, that's what you learn. Do you think the federal government's going to do that? Of course not. So what do we have to do? We have to try to incentivize and find the best alternative to massively grow the economy at the largest peak that we possibly can. And the only way to do that is to keep money in the pockets of individuals, allow them to pay off their debts, allow them to get back on track, lower interest rates, lower the inflation, and then allowing people to start investing again, start buying homes, start buying cars, start buying into investments, start purchasing items again for the sales tax, start traveling around again because gas is going to be really cheap, and start purchasing items that will benefit the local economy and then the state economy and then by default the national economy. And when we do that, then we can start seeing some massive growth. But Republicans just don't get it. Now, we mentioned some of the amendments to this Senate bill yesterday, and Marco Rubio stood on the floor of the Senate during the debate yesterday and made some comments, and I agree with part of what he and Mike Lee from Utah have been working on. I disagree with another part of it. When they want to actually extend the child tax credit to be able to benefit more individuals, totally agree with that. Why not? They say it's part of a welfare thing. Absolutely not. It's just an incentive when you're actually working that you actually have a little bit more of an incentive to take care of your children and a little bit more of a leeway to take care of your children. Is that going to help? Absolutely. Absolutely.
It allows us to change the child tax credit in the current bill to help working families even more. From one, it would make it fully refundable up to the amount you pay in payroll tax. Number two, it would eliminate the marriage penalty, meaning that you would be paying more in taxes if you were a married couple than you would as an individual. Number three, it would index it, the tax credit, to change CPI, which basically means that as inflation grows and the cost of living goes up, the credit doesn't lose its value because it doesn't go up. But the one thing I want to emphasize is, who does this help? Because I've had some people in the past and even today who say, why are you doing this? This is like welfare. I find that offensive. I find it offensive, not because I am offended by people who need the help and are in the safety net program because they've come upon difficult times, but because the people that we are trying to help are not on government assistance. They're workers. You have to work to get this credit. In essence, the credit applies against your tax liability, be it payroll tax or income tax.
All right, so that's Marco Rubio speaking on the floor yesterday during the debate, trying to talk about his child tax credit extension. And then and I agree with that part, totally. Is it welfare? Well, we're incentivizing to the government the same way that we did with the LLCs to some degree, is that we're incentivizing. If you work and you have children and you're struggling because you're working minimum wage, you may be a single parent, you may be whatever, and you're struggling and you need to take care of your kids, that's an opportunity to do so. You are putting in the time and the effort, and guess what? Now we're going to give you an additional tax credit, an extension of a tax credit, and a larger tax credit to be able for that single parent to be able to take care of their kids. That's a great idea. I love it. Fantastic. It's not welfare, it's an incentive. It's to give a little bit of a relief to some of these parents. Now, on the other side of the coin here, the reason what they want to do to reverse this and to do the counter it, which I just don't understand, because they're so paranoid. They're so worried about this $1.5 trillion debt that they think this is going to accrue over the next decade, which is just not the case. It's just not the case. But they want to raise the corporate tax rate from the proposal of 20%. Now, it's 35% currently. They want to drop to 20% in this bill, and Marco Rubio and Mike Lee talking about raising it up to 22%. Why? A 2% increase from the current bill? I don't understand that. I strongly disagree with it. It makes no sense to me on why we would want to raise it and then think that we're doing some kind of justice, except for nothing more than the political BS going on behind the scenes to try and appease some of the moderates so that way they feel more comfortable with this bill.
On the pro-growth side, it's about becoming more globally competitive, and we do so by lower the current corporate tax rate in the United States is 35%. We would reduce that to 22%. Now, the current bill has it at 20, but 22% is just as competitive as 20. Here's why. Just like the current bill, it would be lower than the global average rate of 23%. And just like the current bill, it would move us from last place to third place among the G7 countries. So it's just as pro-growth. It makes us just as competitive, but it allows us to do the pro-worker reform that we desperately need.
Why wouldn't it be allowed to do that with the pro-growth, with the pro-worker thing, without raising up the corporate tax rate a couple of percentage points? Oh, it's still competitive. Doesn't matter. We're trying to make a statement here. We're trying to show that we are going to be pro-growth, and we're going to give corporations massive tax deductions along with individuals at the same time.
This is the Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier on the Mid-America Network.
Welcome back into the Voice of Reason right here on the Mid-America Network. It's a Friday, baby. Let's make it happen. What do you say? 316-721-8255, 316-721-TALK. If you want to join in here, I want to get your thoughts on this tax bill. It's going to be voted on supposedly at 11 o'clock today. Now, I have heard from about three or four different listeners as of yesterday. I encouraged everybody, especially in the state of Kansas, I encourage as many individuals as we can to call our senators. And if you're not in the state of Kansas, then obviously in your state, and call your senator as well. It is extremely important. James Lankford, by the way, from Oklahoma, was one that was kind of sort of teetering on the fence on whether he would support this or not. Not sure why, because we need him to support it big time. Call Senator Lankford. Tell him, hey, it's time to do some major tax reform. That's what we have to do. Now, Jerry Moran here in the state of Kansas has been one that has been on the fence as well. Unfortunately, representing the state of Kansas, oh, hey, I don't know. And the reasoning, supposedly, is the fact that he did not want, Rand Paul had included into the bill, and I don't know if it's still going to be in the final bill or not when they vote on it today, of a repealing of the individual mandate of Obamacare, trying to include Obamacare repeal to some degree into the tax reform bill. And I think it's a brilliant step. If we're not going to be able to do major Obamacare repeal in an Obamacare repeal bill, do exactly what the progressives do, do exactly what the Democrats do, include it into a bill there. I mean, it's a tax. Get rid of the tax. If we're going to talk about taxes, find a way to do it. It's perfect. But Jerry Moran, I don't know if I like that in there. I'll probably support it if they take that part of it out. But I really don't want to repeal that individual mandate because I love Obamacare. I love that idea of expanding Medicaid. I love those things. I heard from about three different listeners yesterday after I had encouraged to call Senator Moran's office just because of the fact that he has been one that was somewhat on the fence there. And all three of them told me that they were very upset with the way it was handled because they called, and from the individual that they talked to said that Senator Moran is still on the fence but leaning towards not supporting or not voting for it because of that individual mandate option of the repeal in there, which, again, I think is a fantastic idea, but obviously he doesn't like that idea. So I tried to call, and I got the exact same responses I have received over the last 2 years of reaching out to him. Oh, that'd be fantastic. We'd love to talk with you. Let me transfer you over, and let me get your name and number over to our communications department, and they'll be in touch with you, and they'll set up an interview. Because I called, and I said, hey, I want to know, first off, how does he plan on voting for this? And the individual, I don't know. I don't have any of that information. Let me take you to the communications department for him, and they'll be able to help you out. I said, okay. While I'm there, though, as well, you don't know how he's going to vote on this. Can I get him on the radio show? We need to talk to our senator to know exactly how he's going to vote. Now, this was midday before they had announced that they're going to delay the vote. So I said, I'd like to have him on the show Friday or early next week after the vote. So that way we can talk about how he voted yay or nay and why. Oh, yeah, that'll be awesome. That'll be fantastic. Let me transfer over to the communications department. They'll be with you. The same response that I've received the five or six different times I've reached out to his office over the last 2.5 years. That'll be great. That'll be perfect. Let me transfer you over to his communications. Nothing. Not a phone call. Not an email. Not a nothing. So, it's up to you. I'm going to continue to try and call when I can. It's up to you, the listener. It's up to you, the constituent. It's up to you, the voter, to make the calls to his offices, the Washington, D.C. office, which apparently they're only taking calls first thing in the morning, but then after that, they're kind of shutting it down because they get too many of them, and they don't want to answer them, so they're not calling them. So you have to call his Kansas offices in Wichita and in Hayes and in Lawrence, wherever else they may be. I don't know. And if you go to his website, you can find those, and I may attach those onto the Facebook Live feed and onto the KQAM and Voice of Reason Facebook pages today, so that way you have the direct link to be able to call his office. I want you to make the phone call. The Democrats have been all over it. They know that Jerry Moran is the wild card that could potentially vote no and sabotage the Republican vote on this. So they have been calling nonstop to Senator Jerry Moran. I don't know about James Lankford. Senator Lankford out of Oklahoma. I know a little bit about him just by some of the investigative committees that he's on, and that's about it. I don't know much about him. I thought he was a solidly conservative individual, but him being one of the potentials of on this tax reform bill, I don't want to see that. And I want to try and get him on the show as well, if it's a possibility here relatively soon, to be able to discuss some of this. But Senator Moran right now is one of the most cautious, to put it nicely, I guess, individuals on whether he's going to support this or not. And it's up to you, the listener, across the entire state, Garden City, Scott City, Dodge City, Wichita, here up in Hutchinson, no matter where you're at, we need to have you call Senator Moran's office. They need to hear from you because the Democrats have done a fantastic job reaching out to him, calling him and urging him to vote no because of the idea of the repealing of the individual mandate, which they despise having in a tax reform. How dare that you try to repeal Obamacare in a tax reform bill? Yeah, but it's actually a tax, and when we're talking about getting rid of taxes, that's really one that we should really be getting rid of. No, you can't be doing that. Call. Make it happen today, preferably before 11 o'clock when they supposedly are going to be voting on this bill. When we come back, we're going to play an interview that we had yesterday with Linda Craighead. She is the head of the Kansas Department of Wildlife, Parks, and Tourism, talking about hunting season. Many of you that did not get to hear yesterday will thoroughly enjoy this. It's a great interview talking about opportunities to get out and enjoy, step away from the tax debate for just a little bit, and be able to enjoy the state of Kansas and the hunting that they have to offer. This is The Voice Reason on the Mid-America Network. It's a Friday. Stay here.
Like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look in 5 and 10, glistening once again.
Are you a Hoosier-holic?
Yeah, baby! Yeah.
Call in now at 721-8255. The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Welcome into the Voice of Reason right here on the Mid-America Network. Happy Friday morning to you. Finally made it, baby. Let's enjoy it, shall we? Let's get her done today. Let's enjoy. You got to work hard to be able to party hard. And that party hard may be whatever you want it to be. Even if it's just sitting and enjoying the evening or visiting with friends or family. Whatever, it doesn't matter. But work hard to party hard, baby. That's what it's all about. 316-721-8255. 316-721-TALK. I want to shift gears a little bit from the tax debate, except for I did just post over the break. I posted all of the phone numbers for all of the offices, including Washington, D.C., and everyone here in the state of Kansas, all of the numbers for Senator Jerry Moran's offices. Every one of them. Call them. I posted them on the KQAM Facebook Live feed. I posted them on the Voice of Reason's Facebook Live feed, and I'll post them on my personal one as well, so that's shared. So it's all over the place. Just go to the Facebook Live feed on KQAM or the Voice of Reason's pages. You can see it there in the comments section. You can see the numbers for Senator Jerry Moran's offices, all of them that they have. Call them. I think they open up at like 8 o'clock, so wait for a couple hours and then call them. And call all of them if you want to. Call every single one of them and make sure. Make your voice heard because it's that important today. I want to shift gears here just for a second and talk about something other than just taxes if we have the last couple of days with some fun stuff happening here in the state of Kansas. Linda Craighead is the head of the Kansas Department of Wildlife, Parks, and Tourism talking about hunting in the state of Kansas. We chatted with her yesterday about some of the hunts, how some of them are going, getting ready for ice fishing season, which that's one thing I have never done, which might be kind of fun to try out sometime. But this is what she had to say yesterday on The Voice of Reason. With the Department of Wildlife, Parks, and Tourism, it's Linda Craighead back on the phone with us here. Linda, good morning. How are you today?
Good morning, Andy. Doing great.
This time of year, even though it seems to be colder and people don't necessarily think about going out and doing things outdoors, that there's a lot of things to do, especially in Kansas, around this time of the season. What's happening in Kansas right now?
Well, you know, Andy, right now is our hunting season, our upland game season. Pheasant season is off to a great start this year in Kansas.
Mm-hmm.
And it started a couple weekends ago and is going to last all the way through the end of January. And if you're not a hunter and you want to learn, you know, just get on board with us. Go onto our website, ksoutdoors.com. Look for opportunities to learn more about hunting. And the other thing that just opened up is our deer season. And Kansas is a terrific destination for a lot of hunters for deer. We are the epitome of a lot of states with respect to hunting and outdoor activities.
Now, are they, for the deer hunting, is it predominantly whitetail or mule deer, or what kind of deer are they around here?
We have both.
Both, okay.
We have whitetail across the entire state. We have mule deer primarily in the western third of the state. So, and obviously we have a few elk, we have a few antelope, we have a little bit of everything from a big game hunter's perspective.
Mm-hmm. I was surprised. I was on the ksoutdoors.com and I was seeing some of the stuff that you can hunt for in Kansas. And I was very shocked and surprised that you do have elk, because I never would have thought that Kansas, I mean, I come from Colorado where you go elk hunting up crazy in the mountains there and at the top of the mountains to go elk hunting. And we used to do bow hunting for that, which is a lot of fun. But I didn't realize that there were elk in the state of Kansas.
There are around the Fort Riley area. On Fort Riley, we have elk. We also have elk out in southwest Kansas.
I remember, and it kind of fell into the political scheme a little bit with the population of them, but what about the prairie chicken? That's around the same season as pheasant this time of year too, isn't it?
It is. The lesser prairie chicken in southwest Kansas is a protected species right now, but however, we do have prairie chicken, the greater prairie chicken, across the western two-thirds of the state. I get into the Flint Hills region of the state, and they are very prevalent. And we're a proud state to offer a mixed bag for hunters. A lot of states are very limited in their offerings,
mm-hmm.
But in the state of Kansas, you have great. In fact, we probably have record breaking quail populations this year.
How fun.
Pheasant population, prairie chicken. So when hunters come to hunt in the state of Kansas, they have a mixed bag opportunity that they don't have in a lot of other places.
What's the most popular here? I know that we have turkey season going on, as you mentioned, the whitetail and or the deer altogether, the elk, the chicken, the pheasant. What's kind of the most popular that people walk away with the most in the state of Kansas?
With the most of, I would say probably quail or pheasant. As far as a trophy perspective, I would say whitetail deer, no question about it. But, you know, I think that you have to remember that hunters aren't hunting just specifically for the game. They hunt because they are true conservationists,
mm-hmm.
because the dollars that they generate from their license sales actually allows our agency to work collaboratively with ranchers and farmers across our great state to offer a habitat that is really conducive to great wildlife. great wildlife habitat.
Oh, it is, absolutely. And I mean, those fees and what you pay towards to go towards to get your license and how you contribute. I mean, we get a bad reputation, and I always laugh at the animal rights activists and the progressives who don't like animal hunting and don't like harming the animals when they don't actually understand how nature actually works. But we, in order to conserve, we're the true conservationists by going out and enjoying the parks, by enjoying and going hunting, by keeping the animal populations regulated to some degree so resources don't become scarce and they die in very miserable ways in that sense.
Absolutely. You know, we really could not do what we do without our partnerships with farmers and ranchers. When it comes right down to it, our farmers and ranchers are the true conservationists. Mm-hmm. We just happen to be a resource for them to help them develop the best habitat possible.
Let's shift gears a little bit to fishing. Do we have any ice fishing in the state of Kansas?
We do.
I love it.
We do. It's probably, I have to admit, that is probably not my favorite thing to do because that cold weather stuff,
it's a little,
you know,
cold.
And you know, here recently with the weather that we've had, that hasn't really been an opportunity. But from what I understand, your weatherman is telling us that things are fixing to change. And so when that ice freezes over, number one, be safe. Mm-hmm. Make sure that you're out in a safe situation. You have somebody with you if you do happen to ice fish. But there are great opportunities across the state to ice fish. And we have some of the best fishing habitat. Our fishing biologists do a terrific job in enhancing our fish populations across the state. Right now, you know, a lot of people don't think about Kansas as being a trout state.
Oh, really?
We have some terrific fisheries that offer trout fishing. Our crew goes out and stocks some of those lakes for the benefit and enjoyment of our fishermen across the state, and it's a lot of fun. And if you haven't caught trout before, I'd really encourage you to think about getting out and doing it.
I love going trout fishing. I've never done ice fishing just because I've had that same fear as you. I'm not a big fan of the cold. And the only time I like the cold is when I'm on a mountain snowboarding. And other than that, I'm not big into bundling up and going out, especially onto the ice. The season this year, you guys have been working on kind of a new project to get people registered to be able to check in, check out, and that's the iSportsman website. Talk a little bit about that and how people can get registered to get their tags and to be able to register checking in, checking out during their hunting experience.
Right. iSportsman is an app that we offer to allow folks to check in, check out. We also have, if you want to go in, you can buy your license at several of our local partners or vendors that work with us, everything from the local bait and tackle shop to our state park offices to even Walmart. And, you know, the other thing that's really nice is you can purchase the license right in the warmth of your own home. Go on to ksoutdoors.com. You can print your own license. And, I want to mention something that's becoming available effective January 1, which you could actually buy, I believe, effective December 15th. But our licenses traditionally have been a calendar year. So when you buy your license in February, it lasts until the end of December. But effective January 1, we're going to a 365-day license.
Wow.
So that way, it lasts an entire year, unlike a lot of states where those licenses might last only 10 days.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're really excited to offer that opportunity for every Kansan and every person across the United States that has an interest in hunting in Kansas. Our whole goal is to make it easier and a lot more fun for every person that comes into the state.
Oh, sure. And I love with that KS Outdoors website, I mean, you have the hunting and the fishing reports to talk about some places where they're good hunting or good fishing and bad places to go where you haven't really seen anything. So you kind of have a lot of these scouting areas already made up for a lot of the hunters and fishers to know exactly where the hot spots are.
Absolutely. And, you know, the other thing that we have is a terrific, we have over a million acres of walk-in hunting. And again, that goes back to our partnerships with the local landowners. But if you could go onto our website and download our atlas. So it's a map that is a section-by-section map. It tells you where those spots are available that you don't even have to go ask permission to hunt because the farmer has already given you that permission in their partnership with us.
How fun.
If you go on to ksoutdoors.com and you download the atlas, if you can download a forecast that tells you kind of where those populations are being found. And most importantly, you can also download the regulations, which tells you what the rules are.
Absolutely.
Because even though a lot of us don't like those rules are in place for a very specific reason. And our job is to help you do the best job you can at conserving our population.
Absolutely. Linda Craighead, the head with the Wildlife Parks and Tourism Department for the state of Kansas. Last question before we let you go, but when it comes to the permits, whether it's turkey, whether it's hunting for deer or pheasants or whatever, are there a cap on those permits that you can get? Do you have to get them in advance, some of them, or are they open all season to where in the middle of the season you can go and purchase that permit? Are there limits and restrictions on those?
There are. There are in specific areas, depending on what you're hunting for, and all of that is outlined on our website. With respect to pheasant, with respect to the hunting license as a whole, you can purchase that year round. You can purchase and apply for your permit year round, but it all depends on whether or not you happen to be the lucky one in some regards, such as deer, such as turkey, to draw those permits.
Very good. That was Linda Craighead. We had her on the show yesterday, head of the Department of Wildlife, Parks, and Tourism for the state of Kansas. And this really goes not just for Kansas, but really for the whole Mid-America region, which is why I thought it was kind of appropriate to play. Even for individuals down in Texas and Oklahoma, we have relatively the same kind of animals and fishing and scenery, I believe, don't we? I mean, at least within our broadcast area here. I know once you get down deeper into Texas and other areas, then it's a little bit different. But we have some of the same areas. We have some of the same hunting, some of the same water issues, some of the same conservation. We are truly, really, honestly, the real conservationists. I know the environmentalist, whatever you want to call them, try to claim to be the environmentalists taking care of the environment, but we are the conservationists. We make sure things are done appropriately. We make sure the animals are taken care of the right way. And we make sure that, I mean, we're not the one to just go out and trash our landscape because we don't really care. That's not what we do. We don't go to places, by the way, and protest the building of an oil pipeline and then just leave it trashed as if we thought that it was a big party scene at a big rave. We don't do that. Left-wing progressives, we actually take care of our environment because we enjoy it, because we understand we live in it. We want the animals to stick around and not disappear, so that way we can continue to utilize them for meat or for scenery or for whatever. There's an ecosystem that we do take care of. We're not the ones that trash that just because we only think about ourselves, left-wing progressives. This is The Voice of Reason. Stay here.
This is The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Up hour number one on the Mid-America Network. Appreciate you hanging out with us today on a Friday, baby. It's a free-for-all Friday. What's on your mind today? Not only is it a free-for-all Friday, but also last week, now they got to enjoy a little time off, but it's a Fried Chicken Friday, as it usually is. Brought to you by the Inman Harvest Cafe right here on The Voice of Reason, 112 South Main Street in downtown Inman, just north of Hutchinson. It's Fried Chicken Friday, the great chicken, the fresh homemade breading every single week, all the pies, all the goodies with it, right in the heart of Inman. Katie's with us. Katie, good morning. How are you today?
Good morning, Andy. Happy Fried Chicken Friday.
Happy Fried Chicken Friday. How are you guys' Thanksgiving?
It was awesome. We got to have a couple of days off. You know, we put so much of ourselves into our food, especially on Fridays, every day, but especially on Fridays. And so it was just kind of a nice, relaxing time to not have to think about it. Even though we love doing it, you know, it's just sometimes it can be a lot. So it was a great time. So.
Absolutely. Very good. I'm so glad. Now, we didn't talk to you last week because you guys were off. But
right.
The week prior to that was the big Thanksgiving Fried Chicken Friday. And I hope that everybody got to go out and enjoy some turkey and some fried chicken and everything that went along with it.
Yeah, you know, it was our single biggest day we've ever had. And I'd like to thank everybody that did come out for their support. It was huge.
How cool.
It was huge.
I love it.
But you know what? If you weren't able to make it, that's all right, you know, because we've got an awesome buffet every single Friday. It's not, you know, it's not a once a year type thing. So, you know, come on out. today. That would be great. We'd love to see you.
I love it. Well, and you're right. Today's the Fried Chicken Friday. Today you have the buffet from 11 to 1 mm-hmm. for the lunch hour. You have the big buffet from 5 to 8 o'clock tonight, which are usually not open that late on normal days. But the Fried Chicken Friday, of course, the big one,
yes.
The big buffet from 5 to 8 o'clock. What's on the lineup for today?
Today we are having, we're trying a couple of new things because, you know, normally we've got, like, leftovers we've got to figure out what we're going to do with from Turkey Day that we freeze and get back out and see what we can redo. But you know what? This time there was, like, nothing left. So we're trying some new things today. And one of the things that we're going to try is a sweet potato apple casserole. And
very
it's kind
nice.
Of a... It's like a, like an apple crisp, okay?
Okay.
Only with sweet potatoes in it, with a crumbly topping, and it's a sweet type, well, sweet potatoes and apples.
Sure.
So, and then it's got a cinnamon nutmeg crumbly type topping on top. So that sounds to me like it's going to be really yummy. And then the other thing that we're going to have is it's called Mom's Chicken Casserole, and it's got, it's got chicken, it's got a saucy stuff, it's got cubed bread that goes on top, and then some cheese. So we're going to do that one.
Very good.
Cheese makes everything it just brings it all together, you know.
Of course. I mean, that's just what it does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then we're going to have ham and scallop potatoes.
Very good.
So those are the things that are going to go along with the regular stuff that we always have, like our homemade mashed potatoes, our vegetables, our gravies, and then, of course, the chicken. And Friday is Pie Day.
It is, of course, Pie Day. We do. Now, we have to remind everybody that for the buffet from 5 to 8 o'clock in the evening tonight, you get your free slice of pie, so you got to get there and get it before it goes away, because once it's gone, well, you're kind of out of luck on that kind of pie. So what pies do you have lined up for today?
So today we've got coconut cream. We've got a chocolate Heath bar. It's got bits of Heath bar in it and on top.
Okay.
Then we've got a sour cream raisin, custard, cherry cream, rhubarb, we've got a pumpkin, and a pumpkin pecan. So those are the pies that we've got out there right now. This afternoon, of course, we'll be making banana split. We make that one at the last minute usually because the bananas turn brown, you know.
Sure.
You cut a banana and you leave it there and it turns brown, it looks ugly. So we usually leave the banana split until the last minute to make that one. So we'll have that out there. And don't forget, in the evening, we always have our famous roast beef.
Yes.
That's always out there. Slow roasted. We try to do it 24 hours. And that'll be out there along with the chicken and everything else. So
I love it. Too many things. You're starting to make people hungry already for breakfast.
I know.
They got to start heading up that way. It's Fried Chicken Friday. It's the Inman Harvest Cafe, 112 South Main Street. Give them a call, 620-585-6925, or visit them online, InmanHarvestCafe.com. Katie, you guys have fun. I'll check in with you here in a couple hours.
All right, thanks. We'll talk to you then.
Very good. Always a pleasure there. Katie with the Inman Harvest Cafe, proud sponsors of The Voice of Reason. We love having them aboard with us here. Wrapping up hour number one, hour two, just around the corner here. This is your show. It's time to speak up, speak out, speak loud, speak proud, speak the truth, and always speak some reason. This is The Voice of Reason. Stay here.
It's time for Reason.
They have really abused their power, saying, well, we're not going to tell you exactly how much money they used to. This is how much money we need to see for it to be, quote unquote, suitable. And that way you're constitutionally compliant. Nowadays, they say, yeah, you know what? We made a mistake back then. We're not allowed to tell you exactly how much because you do have the power of the purse, but only to some degree, because we still get to tell you whether it's constitutional or not. So I can't tell you how much, but you need more money.
This is The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Then I get on my knees.
Welcome into The Voice of Reason, hour number two of The Voice of Reason, right here on the Big Talker, 1480 on the AM side, 102.5 on the FM side, KQAM. It is a Friday. We do it every week. Whatever's on your mind, whatever's troubling you, we open up the lines to you. I am your political therapist. Let's work through it together, shall we? Let's do it. Come on. All right. 721-8255, 721-TALK. If you want to join into the program, you're more than welcome to do so. Shoot me a message on Facebook, on the Voice Reason page, on the KQAM page, and on the Twitter at Hoosier Reason. The Facebook live feed is up and rolling as well. It actually looks like a TV studio in here right now. I mean, it almost looks like a Kim Kardashian like celebrity thing. We have like four different cameras. Let's see, one, two, three. Yeah, four different cameras in here with some photo shots being taken. It's just, what can we say? We're kind of a big deal. That's just what we do. Robin Lace in studio. She's back with us from Colorado. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, Andy?
It's great to be great to have you back here.
Yeah.
Is it snowing back there?
Yeah, we've had a little bit.
I'm so glad I'm not there then.
You know, I laugh though. You know, you were absolutely right. You know, I do think it's my new fitness thing. You know, throw the blankets off, throw the blankets on, throw the blankets off, throw the blankets on. You know, boots on in the morning, flip flops in the afternoon. I love it.
You like that?
Yes, I do.
Living up in the mountains in Colorado, during the summer, you'd be in the mid July.
Yeah, I know.
And it's 80 degrees during the day, and you're sweating. You get a breeze, and it's really cold because there's no. The good thing is there's no. It's a little bit better up there.
It still feels colder here. Crazy.
But then at nighttime, it drops down to 40 degrees as soon as the sun goes down.
I don't care.
And then you got to wear the hoodie. I want to go a place where I don't have to wear a coat at all, let alone have to wear it even in the middle of
They're still wearing shorts over there, Andy. I know.
The weirdos always wear the shorts all year round, and you get those people that, hey, it's negative 10 degrees. I'm going to wear my shorts today.
I'm over here like, okay. But I have a fireplace. Okay, in my RV. So I don't care if it's 20 below.
Oh, well, there you go.
I'm a happy camper.
Always. Glass of wine and
speaking of a happy camper, okay?
See? Right? You brought the guests in studio.
Yes, I did.
You did, and our studio was full, and it's so much fun. Yeah. Who do you have with you? Introduce our guest today.
Dale from Wichita RV. Hi, Dale. Hi,
it's great to get. Now, last time you were here, you were watching me do the crazy makeover.
Yes.
Yeah, that was fun.
Your hair looks great still.
Thank you. Yeah, see, there you go. Yeah. Although I had to go instead of the actual like comb over thing, I had to do the spiky thing again.
Yeah.
I just want to, whatever. Yeah,
it's
be done
good.
With it.
It's all good.
Yeah. But it's still short. I liked it and it's fantastic.
I love it.
Anyways, welcome back in. It's great to see you again. Great to see you again. Now, you guys got some big stuff coming up. We'll talk about here in a little bit when it comes to the RV stuff. A lot of people kind of had the mentality of maybe, well, it's summertime is the RV stuff. Wintertime, not necessarily. But
wrong.
If you're still wanting to travel or do anything with the RV, it's kind of the time to do it now because you can stay nice and cozy warm with a fireplace in your RV.
I know, right?
Come on.
I know. And I have an outdoor kitchen on my RV, too. I'll tell you about that in a minute.
Outdoor kitchen.
Yes, I do. Okay, so I got to tell you my next guest, too. A very, very good friend of mine. I've known this lady forever. Talk about an icon in Wichita. Not just her, but her whole family. Margaret Vance, I love you.
I love you, too. Good morning.
Good morning. Okay, so something horrible happened, you know, and I'm just going to let you kind of tell us what's going on. Wow, this is the whole, you know, Hunter thing.
Okay, so for people who don't know, and this is hard for me to talk about.
Yeah, it's going to be tough.
So my son, Hunter, was a senior at Kansas State University, and the night before he was going back to college, he was been golfing with his friends, and they went on to swim. And sometime during that evening, he had an accident and was paralyzed from his chest down. So it has been more than you can even imagine.
Yeah.
But we are blessed that he is alive. Mm-hmm. And we have been very fortunate that our family has been able to do very well on fundraising. And we have sent him to the country of Panama for stem cell treatments. And so, you know, that's
controversial in itself.
But you need to know that this is his own stem cells. So they actually go into his hips, take bone marrow, and then whatever
find his own little DNA stem cell stuff from his cell.
Right, from himself.
Interesting, okay.
And then they grow it and then inject it into him for several hours every day for a month period.
He's been there twice?
He's been there twice, and we're getting ready to go the third time. Now, this procedure is horrible to say, but I am thankful that he can't feel anything because it's terrible.
Right.
Just the procedure of extracting the bone marrow. And as you know, for anybody who does go through bone marrow transplants, I mean, that's what they talk about is how terrible the pain is when they go through this. But he has migraines all night long. He throws up. I mean, it's very much, it's just
painful.
Painful. It's a lot. So my husband had quit his job he's a contractor. He owns his own business. He had just stopped working for 30 days to go up for this, to stay with him night and day to help him. And so after the accident, they said there is no way that he is going to be able to move his hands or move anything. So after the first stem cell treatment, he is able to move his right hand.
Wow.
And his left ring finger.
Wow.
So, I mean, that in itself is monumental. It's a miracle.
Sure.
It is.
So the second time back, He started to get feeling and, you know, more motion. And we're just, you know, we're just hopeful. Yeah. You know, we have huge amounts of people in town who pray for us.
Yes.
Which we think is, you know, the number one thing. But we are getting ready to go back for round three. And in the middle of fundraising for this.
Yeah. You guys are doing something pretty big. If you want to put that in front of your camera for a minute. Can you explain that one to us? Because that's huge.
Okay. So we were getting ready to have a large fundraiser that was postponed. And we had tickets for two big events for Pink. The concert's coming up in March. And these tickets are primo tickets. Yeah. And for next weekend's Trans-Siberian Orchestra, which is also
yes,
yes, yes.
Love those guys.
I love that show. So for Trans-Siberian Orchestra, we have four tickets. Uh-huh. And for Pink, we have two tickets. And so this Friday, there's a raffle for Trans-Siberian Orchestra. Tickets are $5 each, five for $20. For both events, you just have to specify which one you want so that you don't just end up random with the wrong show.
Yeah, and where can people go buy these raffle tickets, honey?
They can contact us online. I've got it under my own Facebook page of Margaret Vance.
Okay.
And
Javetta's helping.
Right. Javetta Slane's on there. Uh-huh. Janet Steven, my sister. Julie Prater, who's very active in Junior League. And I've got Christy Glover. So, but the big place you can go by, if you just say, hey, who are these people? Just go by Kaylane's Boutique.
Yeah.
It's right there on Kellogg and Tyler. Fabulous
place. Fabulous place. Oh, love the clothes.
Gosh. Yeah. Wonderful clothes, but just go on in there and load up.
Yeah. So the tickets are just like a raffle, and this is a donation to help. I don't know, Margaret understands, but, you know, being over there in Colorado just in the last couple of weeks, we've had, you know, medical refugees, what else do you call them? And these are parents. In the last case that I helped work with, it was a parent trying to get her child over to Colorado because of the amount of seizures. And there's organizations over there that, you know, you get set in a home. There's organizations that help pay for your rent, pay for your utilities, you know, and get you set up with different medical experts. The county that I live in, the new city that I live in, La Vida, we are putting in a huge research and development. We have doctors coming in from all over the world. So this is going to be a big research and medical development facility in La Vida, Colorado.
I had to go there.
I know, right? I mean, but I just helped, you know, a parent and her child get over there and get to safe residency get with the medical people they need to get with. So it is real. It doesn't matter if you're trying to leave a state to another state because of, for instance, a cannabis situation, or you have to leave the United States to another country, you know, to get the medical assistance that you need. Margaret, I feel for you and your family.
Thank you.
You're always going to be in our prayers. I love you. And please, if you guys can, get out there and do these $5 raffle tickets. I mean, come on, Pink and Trans-Siberian, you can't.
And premium seats.
I know these are going to be good seats, right?
But I wanted to tell you one thing about this real quick. I think it's very sad, and you're talking about this is your political program, that we have to go out of the country for this. Now, the stem cells, they're saying, well, they do this in Wichita. They do not do the same amount of stem cells. So he receives millions and millions of stem cells every single day versus 100,000 here.
Oh, wow.
So, and it's not like where someone would say, well, if you get too much, then, you know, it's not good for you. I mean, I feel just the opposite. Give him everything that you can't get things.
Throw it all at the wall and see what sticks, kind of thing.
Right. I mean, you know, this is healthy cells that are attaching to the damaged cells to help them repair.
Well, it's another unique side of the stem cell research that I haven't even really heard of, that I don't know many people have been familiar with, because when you hear about stem cell research, you hear about predominantly the idea of, you know, harvesting different things from, you know, from abortion and from that side of it, that is really given it the bad name.
Right.
And I'm not for that in any way, shape or form. But if you're taking it from the person themselves already and trying to grow it in that sense, it's a whole other side of it that I didn't even know that was possible. I mean, I guess it could have been, but I guess we never even talked about it really in the mainstream.
I think that goes back with a lot of times, you know, our media, and we, most of us in this room do media, right? You know, so you get on a story, you know, oh, stem cell, oh my God, that's abortion, you know, and you just want to see that not so good positive side.
It's just
of
where they're getting the stem cells from,
right?
Is the question.
But there's not a lot of education out there, Aunt Margaret, on what you're going through.
That's right, and I do wish my husband was here, because all night long, every night, he watches stories, and, you know, just anybody who's looking for any new research. There is a new spine surgery that there is a doctor that is performing in Germany, but it is a long ways away for us. We're so interested. It's implanting a sensor on the spine that kind of blocks the brain to knowing that there's any damage. Hmm. But it's in a very, very preliminary stage. But unfortunately, you know, we're ready. We're ready. We want to walk.
Right. Right.
And, you know,
I think this would be another case to try and advocate for the repealing of Obamacare so we can actually allow these types of research to actually happen in the private market where things actually are more productive in the first place.
I say bring it on. We need these types
of another great argument for something like that. Let's go ahead and take a break here. We got the great guests. We got lots of things to talk about. Also, I got to throw the story out when we come back as well and get you guys' take on this. I found it kind of comical, and for Thanksgiving holiday, it may seem relatively appropriate. So we'll talk about that when we come back as well. Lots to get to, of course, your thoughts and calls as well. 721-8255-721-TALK. This is The Voice of Reason on KQAM. Stay here.
You're listening to The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier on The Big Talker, KQAM.
Hey, jingity jing, it's Dominic the Donkey, jingity jing.
Here we go.
The Italian Christmas Donkey, la la la.
This is, by the way, the best Christmas song. End of it. That's just it.
Okay.
Best Christmas song.
Cheech and Chong Christmas? Or have I just been in Colorado too long?
The Cheech and Chong. Oh, wait a second. Yeah, well, there we go, too. That's right. Welcome back into The Voice of Reason right here on the Big Talker KQAM. 721-8255-721-TALK. It truly is the most classic Christmas song that you can play.
It is.
Although the other one that's a close toss-up is the Winter Wonderland by Ozzy Osbourne and Jessica Simpson together.
Yeah, that's okay, too.
Yeah, see, that's another classic. Right, Absolute classic.
Yeah.
Got to be played on the mainstream Christmas radio stations.
Yes, you have to do that.
That's what you have to do. Robin Layson, great guest here in studio. Before we get into the next one, we're wrapping up the Thanksgiving holiday, getting into the Christmas holiday. Let me get your thoughts on this.
Okay.
Story came out today. Man kicked out of an all-you-can-eat buffet at Golden Corral because he's one of the heavier individuals and ate more than 50 pounds of food. Got kicked out of the Golden Corral and now is suing them for $2 million because of false advertising, saying that it's an all-you-can-eat buffet and you stopped me and cut me off after eating more than 50 pounds of food.
50 pounds?
50 pounds of food.
God.
There you go.
Okay, yeah.
Does he have a legit reason to sue?
No, I don't think so.
Or do they have a right to kick him off and cut him off?
I say cut him off.
He's one of those, you know, one of the, like the 700-pound individuals that, you know, has a, and yeah.
Dude, seriously, that's not healthy for him. Cut him off.
It's totally not healthy, but they did say all-you-can-eat buffet. I don't know.
Well, there's a difference between buffet and you know, like a trough.
Absolutely.
I mean, Hey, I'm a farm girl again. I'm going to say trough.
There you go. So, yep, suing for $2 million after being cut off after eating 50 pounds of food at Golden Corral.
I think maybe they should do like all-you-can-eat buffet, pound
limit of 10 pounds of
limit
food.
Limit of 10 so many pounds, you know?
You're done.
You're done, yeah. Or just start selling it by the pound.
There you go, yeah.
That's not a bad idea.
Yeah, exactly. There you go.
Yeah, that'll be interesting.
Yep.
Oh, well, never a dull moment. But I want to switch for just a minute over to some fun stuff. RV.
RVing. And again, we got to remind you, I mean, when I think of an RV, the first thing that pops into my mind is summertime camping.
Yeah.
And that's the first thing that people, it's summertime camping, you get out there, you go enjoy the wilderness out there, and that way you don't have to sleep on the ground, which I like sleeping on the ground sometimes, but luxuries of the RV.
Yeah.
And if you one of these days, and I think I said this last time too, when I get to that retirement age stage, I want to get the RV, not have a house, and just travel around the country.
Yeah, I sold my house.
That.
Exactly.
And that's what you're doing right now.
I sold my house in Wichita. And I really did not think I was going to be a full-time RVer. I really didn't. But I'm so glad I am.
And isn't it fun?
Oh, I love it.
And one of these days when I'm a syndicated radio host and I can just broadcast, and it'd be like, today I'm broadcasting from.
Wherever
I'm at in the country that day.
And
it'd be kind of fun.
Idea.
Well, see, the thing I love is, you know, like I said, the fireplace, right? I told you about an outdoor kitchen. It's to die for. And it doesn't feel like I don't feel like I'm in an RV. Okay. Mine has three slides. So I have an actual bedroom. By the way, I have a 50-inch TV in my bedroom. See? And, you know, there's a fireplace and, you know, there's a dining room table and chairs. You know, this is like a home on wheels. It is my home on wheels. But then you have all this. I'm like, oh, my God, there's an outdoor kitchen? Hello?
Okay, so that's part of the RV?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, so what's included with the outdoor kitchen? I mean, the whole shebang?
Okay, I get so excited. People are like, you have a what? And then I get excited. So break it down for them, okay?
Okay.
Dale, Wichita RV, tell us, babe.
On yours, you have a outdoor grill.
Yes.
That is direct line into the coach where you can just run it off the propane.
Yep.
You have a sink, you got a refrigerator, you can put a TV out there and watch, you know, sports or whatever.
While you're cooking and eating.
While you're cooking. And then you're outdoors.
50-inch TV outside, too.
And, you know, it's just the way to live. You can go out
there and
just have fun, enjoy the outdoors, and make your meals outside.
It's fantastic. Go. And we have a hot tub.
And she has a hot tub out there.
Okay. Yeah, is there a hot tub that was included in the RV?
No, it wasn't included. Don't get me in trouble, Robin. I know you're going to get me in trouble. No, I'll let you talk about that because that's kind of your thing. But I think I saw a picture of it, and there's a picture out there. It is
isn't that awesome?
Awesome.
Okay, now I've got to ask a question.
Yeah, honey.
This. Now, most people kind of get the RV to kind of travel and see the world, but you kind of like...
I've seen the world.
These TVs, it just doesn't seem like that fits at all. You know, I mean, you moved to Colorado to get away from the big city.
Yeah,
but you brought it with you.
Here's the perfect scene. You're sitting outside in the lawn chair. You got the mountains in the background.
Right.
You got the deer walking behind you, and you're sitting there watching the football game or it's the MMA fight because we're not watching the NFL
Netflix.
While they're doing their protests. Netflix, while you're sitting there outside in the mountains all around. I mean, it's a perfect kind of scene
it's
there.
It's crazy.
Right there.
And thanks to, again, Wichita RV, I bought this, I think it's GoSun is a product, but they have these cool solar ovens. And so RVing does not mean that you don't have to be just in a tent or feel like you're in a box.
Sure.
It's a home, you know, with kitchens inside, outside, TVs, stereos. The first night I got over there, we were so excited, turned the stereo on. And the outside speakers were on too, and everybody was like, "Well, dang, the partiers are here!"
Yeah. You know, and it's a party.
It's a party
every day.
Then we set up a hot tub a couple weeks later, and they're like, "Dang!" So RVing has changed; it really, really has. But you know, I still have I don't know, some of my old school RVers that'll come by, and they're like, "What is all this?" You know, and then they're like, "Honey, I gotta go over there with the RV and get one of these. I ain't doing mine ever again."
Exactly.
You won't. But the price is to die for.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. So my brand new home on wheels with the fireplace, with a cool bathroom, the most amazing bedroom. I can put my 50-inch TV in my bedroom, my living room, outside. I have a hot tub. I have all this cool stuff for less than you could get a home, even in Wichita, in Colorado. I love it.
Very good. Very good. We'll continue this and more. Lots to get to. It's open lines to you as well. It's a Friday. It's a free-for-all Friday. Whatever's on your mind. So much to touch on as we're in between the great holidays, as we're wrapping up the year, getting ready for January 2018. This is The Voice of Reason.
Beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Andy never shies away from a fight.
I'm gonna deck your halls, bub.
And now's your chance to jump in the ring. Give Andy a call at 316-721-8255. This is The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Welcome back into The Voice of Reason, 721-8255, 721-TALK. You're more than welcome. I love debates. I really do. Allegedly, at least. By the way, speaking of that clip, that little clip in the liner, do you remember what movie that's from? You remember that one?
Yeah, no.
No?
Sorry.
No? Jingle All the Way, Arnold Schwarzenegger beating up all the Santa Claus in the back. Come on! What is this? That is by far the best Christmas movie, and... Last weekend after Thanksgiving, ended up putting up the Christmas tree on Black Friday, putting up all the lights and everything. Had that movie on in the background, watched it twice. Fantastic. Now we got the upcoming Christmas movies of Die Hard and Lethal Weapon and the traditional Christmas classics.
All right,
Ready to go.
We're talking about movies, Mike Furches.
That's right, Mike Furches. That's right. Ah, we can't be doing that. By the way, talking about some of the health stuff, when we talked about the stem cell, we do have a guest coming on the show in a couple weeks here, a doctor about some of the home remedies for the cold and sinus issues for the winter time, because that is one of the more frustrating times of the year. And is now that we're, especially with you guys in Colorado, going back and forth between the warm and the cold, you get sick more often. Here in Kansas, we're still, I mean, now we're starting to finally go down a little bit cooler. But last weekend for Thanksgiving was 70 degrees here.
I know.
It was fantastic.
Oh, we've had 70 degree days. It's beautiful.
Yeah. I try, although one of the remedies that they have here, they said would get rid of the sinuses and the cold stuff. I tried it. It is the most god-awful thing you'll ever try, and it did not work for me.
What was it?
Did you even know about... I didn't even know oregano oil.
Yeah.
is the most intense, gross, terrible stuff you will ever try in your life. And you're supposed to put like 5 drops of it under your tongue. Oregano oil. And it burns. I've never felt a burning like that before. I couldn't feel my tongue for an hour. I came into the show that morning after doing it, and I still could not talk properly. I could not taste all day. You put it under you're supposed to put it under your nose to breathe and clear your sinuses.
Yeah, right.
No. It burns your nose. It's terrible. I don't know what this person's like. So I got a beef to pick with them when they come on the show here in a couple weeks. Because never try oregano oil. No, don't do it.
Go for it. It's not going to hurt you.
Oh, it's terrible.
You need to stick to hot toddy. And then you'd be
fine. Yeah, exactly. Hot toddy. Here's my remedy for... And this is when you go to bed. You take the hot shower to try and sweat it out. You take about 3 shots of whiskey. Then you take about a shot of the NyQuil and then a couple Advil. You sleep great. You feel wonderful in the morning. That's my remedy. It's perfect.
Okay, some of that shouldn't go together.
I was going to say, I wouldn't be mixing that, man. Yeah, not a good idea.
Okay, talk to my 90-year-old father who, when I was a little girl, he would come home and have two fingers of Canadian Club.
There you
go.
And
they would go take a nap and felt better when
that's
he woke up.
That's fantastic.
So just
That's right.
Don't add those other things.
Don't add the Advil.
And the NyQuil.
NyQuil
and whiskey. That made me sleep so perfect. I woke up feeling so great after that. It was fantastic.
I'm so happy you woke up.
You slept for 2 days.
Well, that's not telling.
Actually, it's funny. My wife. I usually toss and turn. I wake up numerous times the night. My wife was like, I had my hand on your chest all night because you weren't moving.
Make sure you were still breathing.
I was like, hey, that was the best sleep I've had in 10 years. Anyways, welcome back. 721-8255-721-TALK. Not recommended by any doctors. That's the voice of reason.
Don't go to
any
medical experience.
This is the Dr. Andy speaking here, and that's probably not one that you want to take seriously. But anyways, oregano oil, don't try it. Don't do it. It was terrible. Worst thing ever. Anyways, RVs.
Yeah, I want to make sure that everybody in Wichita, Kansas, and even my friends in Colorado, Missouri, Texas, Oklahoma, when I decided to, we had another motorhome before we bought our new one, and it was a motorhome. So I can talk to you about that. I think the thing I like about a motorhome versus a travel trailer is the amount of storage I have underneath my unit. Believe me, I don't miss it right now. I'm absolutely in love. So if you look at RVs and trying to purchase an RV, okay, from anywhere in the United States, because please, I mean, my home is on wheels. I'll go anywhere I want to go, okay? So I've been pricing and looking and shopping and shopping and, oh, my God, for probably 3 years. And I think I called Wichita RV and I'm like, here's what I want. I see it on your website. Here's what I need. Here's what I want to do, da-da-da-da. And they were like, come on in. I went, wow. So it's very simple with these guys. They really work hard with you, but they have a big event coming up in January here in Wichita at the Hartman Arena, January 10th through the 14th. It's the Wichita RV and Outdoor Show. So, gosh, what's going to be going on? I can hardly wait. I wish I could be here.
Well, this is going to be our first year out at Hartman Arena, so we're very excited for that. We are going to have Wichita RV, actually the Wichita RV company, because there's the Wichita RV show, Wichita RV outdoor show. This is actually Wichita RV, the company. We're having our own event this year, and we are going to have, obviously, all of our inventory out there, most of our inventory out there. It's all going to be opened up. It's all going to be lit up. Nice heated building when it's cold out. Come out, and when you guys have that cabin fever, come out and look us up and come out and see us. We're also going to have a few other vendors out there. Some are to be announced.
As you get closer?
Yeah, as we get closer. But we're looking at having some golf carts out there, lawnmowers, you know, just a lot of the outdoor equipment that people want to
go look at.
And especially after being... Obviously, it's kind of hard right now because the weather's so nice. But, you know, in the past years, everybody has a cabin fever. They want to get outside. They want to start planning for the spring. So we're going to kick that off January 10th through the 14th. The times will be announced. You can look them up at the Hartman Arena website. We're going to start posting them on our website. But it'll be Thursday through Sunday. So
that's going
to
be so cool.
We're very excited to have it this year. And
are there big special prices?
Yeah, absolutely. The pricing's going to be, we're going to work with everybody to fit their budget and get them into something, and tons of discounts. We're going to have some giveaways. We're just going to have a lot of fun. You know,
it'll be fun. Awesome. It'll be cool. Yeah. And if you've never been to an RV show, I'm like a kid in a candy store at an RV show.
I think I went to one as a kid.
Oh, I love them.
And maybe in Ohio when they had one. They had,
I don't think we've had one for a while. We went a couple years here where we didn't really have one in Wichita for a bit.
We did, but the whole thing, it's changed over the last few years from six dealers to three dealers to, you know, so they've changed it. And we said, you know what, we're going to do it on our own this year.
I'm so glad you guys are doing it.
And we're going to change it up. We're not going to do the same old, same old.
Right.
That was one of the complaints we were having, that people would come out and say, this looks the same as it did last year.
Right.
You know, so we want everybody to know it's going to be different. It's going to be fun.
Right.
You know, come out and, you know, even if you're not out there to buy an RV, there's going to be other stuff to look at.
Check out that solar cooking stuff. Man, I'm still blown away by that.
Solar cooking stuff.
We bought a unit from Wichita RV when we, you know, bought our rig, and it's GoSun is the brand, and they're solar cooking ovens that don't take up any space, and they're so cool. So you'll be seeing a chef, a very well-trained, phenomenal chef over in Colorado, in La Vita. And she's from Connecticut. Phenomenal. Everything from homemade pies to the best, you know, fried chicken and chicken fried steak and all that. So she's going to be doing a cooking show, RV style, a chef in my RV, my outdoor kitchen, my GoSun stuff. Yeah. So we're kind of be helping you to see how fantastic these things are.
Well, talk about some of the GoSun?
GoSun. GoSun is a product line that you guys have.
Yes. Yeah. Basically what it is it's they have different ovens, barbecues where you stick in whatever you want to cook, whether it's meat, whether it's
veggies,
cookie dough, veggies, anything, and you set it out in the sun.
There you go.
Just cooks it up.
Cooks it right up.
Yeah. Solar cooking.
Is that something that you can buy for anybody?
Yeah,
You don't have to be an RVer.
You need to let people know about
Hey, when they were on
camping and all, you know,
When you guys go on Cake TV over on our TV station, take one of those suckers, man. They are so cool.
And leave it so that we can.
Absolutely.
Because you can't have
mine. Practice a little bit. That's right.
Hey, well, what about if you've got a hot tub with your RV? Then you need to have hot tubs there.
I think they're gonna. Yes. I think they're gonna try to do that.
We're working on that right as we speak.
Ours just blow it up.
She's spoiling everybody and.
I've never even heard of any of this before because I've always had a different vision of RVs. And then I just saw a photograph of yours.
Yeah, I know.
And it's kind of like, oh my gosh.
Is that crazy or what? I'll put some on your page, Andy, and you can share them, okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
Very deluxe.
Yeah. It's not like it used to be.
No.
You know, I mean, keep in mind, when I was a little girl, that's what we did. I used to look so forward to Dad had a truck and he had a camper on top.
Right.
You know, and we could, I was tiny and I could slide through the window in the back of the truck, you know, and into the camper. And it was so cool. That's all we did. That was our big thing. We went to Bull Shoals, Arkansas. We went to Colorado many times, you know. So growing up, I was a camper girl, fishing and hunting and all that.
And now you're an elite camper girl.
Yeah. Well, I don't know about elite. I'm just a happy camper girl. I make it look elite, though.
one of the other changes that you'll see, you know, from the, you know, 15, 20 years ago is, and we talked about this a little bit last time, but the size of the RVs that they're doing now. I mean, we have some 15 to 20 foot RVs that have a lot of room in them.
Yeah.
That you can tow with a car.
I know that car. You know? I know.
So that's one of the other things. And we have a few that have, quote unquote, they're extreme packages, so you can go off roading. That you know, and you mentioned earlier, Andy, about you know the time of year, it being summer and
right.
You know, but the thing is, some of these are built that you can go out in the winter. We sell them to hunters that go out.
I was
out.
Just going
to
ask about the hunting season.
Yes.
For the hunters.
And, we still have them over there.
Yeah, they're insulated, so you can go out. You can stay out there. You don't
are
have
they
to worry
camouflage?
About. Not yet.
Okay.
But, the funny thing is one of them that we sell actually just signed up a partnership with Mossy Oak. They are going to actually have some camouflage.
That
different
just made
things
my day
out.
Right there.
Yeah, so now you have to get one. You know?
Now you have
get
to.
Camouflage one, that's right. Yeah.
Well, you know, the other thing I like too, over there I'm at, you know, the big attractions are like the dunes. Mm-hmm. Okay, so a lot of the rigs too have that room in the back to put your dirt bikes, you know, your four wheelers. It's the new homes on wheels, man. I'm telling you, they're you're gonna have a hard time getting me to buy a home again. Really?
Sure.
Yeah, I'm not kidding.
That is the home now.
It is. I love
wanted to throw some out there on the GoSun. You can go to GoSun stove.com
right.
and look at all their products, you know. So for anybody that's interested into what Robin and
GoSunStove.com.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep.
Very
yeah.
fun.
Okay, Wichita RV, you guys have two locations here
yes.
in Wichita.
Yes.
And you mentioned you're going to try to get the majority of the rigs in Hartman Arena?
Yes.
Well, oh,
we are going to, well
okay.
I wouldn't say all of our inventory.
Okay, thank you.
But we are going to, I'm hoping to have somewhere in the range of 50 units out there.
Wow.
And we are going to have some outside.
Yeah.
Because we're limited on space uh-huh. on the bottom of there, but we will have some outside.
Okay, because so. We're driving in last night, you know, and of course I go right by the West Kellogg Wichita RV, and I'm like, "Slow down, honey!" And he's like, "What?" And I'm like, "Look at that way! Look at that one! You know, you guys are packed on West
yes,
Kellogg.
We
you
are.
Got
we're
some gorgeous units.
Yes.
Wow!
Yes.
Wow! So, this is going
to
be
people
so
need
much
to
fun.
Go out and take a look because we're ready to move some units. So
West Kellogg
that time of year and East Kellogg.
Yeah, addresses.
You're gonna
proximity.
Ask
proximity.
Well, basically, Mays and Kellogg across yeah. the street from where we are now.
Right now,
and then we're out in between Andover and Augusta, straight across from the Augusta Airport. If anybody, the pumpkin patch is out there, we're straight yeah. across the street.
There you go.
About 3 miles east of Andover Road.
And he's not kidding when he says now's the time of year to buy an RV. That's so true. You buy them in like, you know, that November, December, January, February time here in Wichita because these guys are making phenomenal deals. I'm not
Absolutely.
Kidding. Better mm-hmm. than Oklahoma, better than Texas, better. You know, like I said, I've shopped almost every state RV dealers. It's kind of crazy that I would do that, but I would do that. And they're making the best deals. I'm not kidding.
Very good.
Not kidding.
I love it. I love it. Got to take a break here. Wrapping up hour number two already. So much to get to. The lines are always open to you as well. Can you believe it? We're almost done with hour number two. It's the Voice of Reason. It's a Friday. It's a free-for-all Friday right here on KQAM.
This is the Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Fantastic.
Gotta love it.
Wrap it up. We got about 3 minutes left to the show, but let's go over again one more time the contact info for Wichita RV. Also, what you have going on with the STEMSA, with the fundraising, with the events, with the ticket giveaway, Trans-Siberian Orchestra being Christmas time, is if someone has not gone, one of the coolest concerts to ever go
awesome.
To. I love it.
Yeah.
Great.
Absolutely
awesome.
Fantastic.
Okay, so we are going. Hunter Vance is my son, who is a quadriplegic, had an accident the night before he went away to senior year. Mm. And this is a fundraiser where we're just selling raffle tickets. Buy one for five for $20. And the tickets are for either Trans-Siberian Orchestra or they are for Pink. And they are
Very
fabulous
good.
Seats to both of them. So you can go online on Facebook and look up Margaret Vance or Team Hunter. And or you can go by Kaylane's Fashion Boutique, which is on Kellogg and Tyler. They open at 10 o'clock.
Very good. Now, just out of curiosity, with the stem cell process, you said that they harvest the stem cell and they grow. How long does that process take?
That actually just takes 2 days.
For the growing of it?
For the growing
really?
Of it.
Really?
It's, you know.
Wow.
It's technology, it's science. And that
how does it work? I mean, do they stick it in like a little Petri dish thing and let it grow and do its thing? And then I don't know how this works.
Well, I would have to have my husband tell you all the details of it.
How
but
fun.
But it is. It's a major thing. And it is so unfortunate that it is so outrageously expensive.
Yeah.
Because there are so many people here who have quadriplegic children or family members
that
could
had
an accident.
Yeah.
You know, and they, you know, you just can't go there. It's ridiculous. This is not done in the United States.
Wow.
I agree.
Absolutely. Wichita RV as well. How do we get a hold of you guys?
Well, you can call us at 316-733-7777 or 316-559-2900. You can visit us at wichitarv.com. Also, as far as the RV show coming up, you can come out and get tickets from us. They're $5. Or you can also get them at the day at the door when you come in and see us. We're going to have a ticket boost there. Again, it's just, at Hartman, just $5 to get in. So.
That is amazing. $5.
Absolutely. $5 to be able to get in for that. I love it. It's fantastic.
Well,
thank you guys so much for coming
thank
in studio
you.
Here. Merry Christmas to you.
Same to
and
you.
It's going to be a great 2018. Robin, are you going to be here next Friday?
No, I'm back in Colorado.
You're back in Colorado. Yeah. You're enjoying the mountains right there. Well, perfect. Well, we won't see you, but I'm sure we'll talk to you next Friday. Really, it's next Friday, kind of the one wrapping up our projects for the year and looking forward to 2018 as well. So
got a lot coming to you in January. Watch out.
It's going to be crazy.
I know.
It's going to be a good time. Merry Christmas to all you guys. Appreciate
Merry Christmas.
It. Hour number three, The Voice Reason, coming up here in just a minute. It's Open Line Friday to you. Stay tuned here on KQAM.
It's time for Reason.
They have really abused their power, saying, well, we're not going to tell you exactly how much money they used to. This is how much money we need to see for it to be, quote unquote, suitable. And that way you're constitutionally compliant. Nowadays, they say, yeah, you know what? We made a mistake back then. We're not allowed to tell you exactly how much because you do have the power of the purse, but only to some degree because we still get to tell you whether it's constitutional or not. So I can't tell you how much, but you need more money.
This is the Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier. Then I'll get on my knees.
Of Reason, hour number three of the Voice Reason right here on the Big Talker, 1480 on the AM side, 102.5 on the FM side, KQAM. It is a Friday. We do it every week and no guests this hour. It is an open line to you. You can call in and complain or vent or discuss anything that you'd like to do so. It's a free for all. Come on. Let's make it happen. All right. 721-8255, 721-TALK. If you want to join into the program, I want to hear from you today. What's on your mind? Shoot me a message on Facebook, on the Voice Reason page, on the KQAM page, on the Twitter, at Hoosier Reason. Along with Facebook Live feed we have going on, you can check that out as well. Leave a comment, share it, like it. Let's spread the word. Let's advance conservatism on a daily basis. No guests this hour. It's really hard, and I feel bad because we always call it a free-for-all Friday and an open line to you to be able to talk about what you want to, and then we always have so many guests, which is great, and I love the guests, but we never have time to open it up to you. So the hour number three today, it's totally open to you. You can talk about anything. You can talk about the tax reform. You can talk about President Trump. You can talk about whatever may be happening in the community. You can talk about anything that you want to. It's completely wide open to you. 721-8255-721-TALK. If you have noticed and been checking out the Facebook Live feed, I am wearing the suit today. I do plan on heading out to the Pachyderm Club this afternoon at lunchtime as Governor Brownback will be speaking to kind of do his farewell. He's kind of been on his farewell tour until he leaves. Now, was it yesterday? Or day before, a couple of days ago, he was out in Washington, D.C. meeting Mitch McConnell, the Senate Majority Leader, as he's talking about, hey, when are you guys actually going to vote on me? We still hear the individuals criticizing President Donald Trump for not actually getting the appointments into the positions that they need to. And is it necessarily his fault? No, of course not. Because the Senate's still sitting on 20 or 30 or 40 of them waiting to actually vote to actually make them go into positions, and it's unfortunate. Now, the good news, and I know that you've probably heard the news and seen the newspaper and seen the TV, but Mike Pompeo, our very own homegrown Kansas boy, as he was Congressman Mike Pompeo for the 4th Congressional District, then he was CIA director, now it sounds like potentially that as of the middle of January that he may become the new Secretary of State as Rex Tillerson may be out the door. And just imagine how cool it is to have the Secretary of State be from right here in our area, be from right here from the Wichita area. How cool. I mean, we got to be proud of that. Now, some are saying, it's just setting them up for failure. I don't think so. Donald Trump, regardless of whether you like Donald Trump or dislike Donald Trump has a knack for picking individuals for positions that know how to get the job done. He runs a business, for crying out loud. He knows exactly who to nominate, exactly what positions to put them in, and sometimes it takes a little bit. Now, the difference is that so far he's been a business individual and he knows what business needs to be done. He knows what the position in his business, in his corporation, in the construction companies, and the whatever he's been doing on who to put there in those right positions. The hard workers, the ones that get her done, the ones that actually do it efficiently, the ones that actually show up and make sure the job is done the way that President Trump, or at that time, a business owner, Donald Trump, wants to be done. He knows how to do that. Now, when he got into the government side of this and he transitioned to become president of the United States, a little bit different beast, right? And as some of you may have been there, some of you did not, a lot of you did not, when Corey Lewandowski showed up, the Trump advisor and the former campaign manager for President Trump, when he came into town and talked a little bit, you could tell, and it wasn't very, it wasn't a shocker, really, of the government workers at the White House, they were slackers. They're on the government dime. They're working government hours. They don't really care. And when Donald Trump walked in, that's what he was up against. And you got to get people in there that are not bureaucrats, that do not care about the way that things have been done before. And you need to make sure someone gets in to be able to get the job done appropriately. Now, Donald Trump had the knack to be able to choose Mike Pompeo to become the CIA director, and I was very proud of that. I was very happy for Mike Pompeo, and I'm so glad that he's in that position. He's worked. He's been loyal. He's been dedicated. We heard that when he was the congressman for the 4th Congressional District, that he ran his district and his office in D.C. and here locally as a business. It was a very tight-knit ship. It was a very efficient operation. And that is why I think that President Trump has seen that in Mike Pompeo. He knows his work ethic. He knows how he does things. And and I think it's been very beneficial. So that's why I think that he now absolutely, by the way, understanding the CIA side of it and the monitoring and the potential dangers and the terrorist threats and everything that the CIA does to monitor individuals and the inside scoop from that side would be extremely beneficial to step into the Secretary of State position and be able to work with different foreign governments. It's absolutely phenomenal. This could, in my opinion, and maybe you have a different one, but I want to hear from you on that if you do, I think this could be the best choice that Donald Trump has made so far in his cabinet, by far. And it's from right here in Kansas. Now, we're going to do what we can to reach out. I have not been able to get the CIA director, Mike Pompeo, on the show. But if we're able to get Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on the show, then we'll try and actually do that to welcome him, to congratulate him, and for him to remember the little guys out here in Wichita, Kansas. 721-8255-721-TALK. We do have the vote coming up in just a couple hours, 11 o'clock Eastern time, 10 o'clock our time, and just 2 hours from now, the vote on tax reform is going to be happening in the Senate, unless they pushed it off. And I've not seen anything yet that they have pushed it off as of right now. It's still going to happen. It's still a go. They pushed it back last night after they actually, it sounds like, the Bob Corker amendment of wanting to do the automatic tax increases if they don't hit projections. If they don't do the projections as they see fit, and then they automatically, bam, tax increase. As their nice little safety net, which we talked about many times yesterday, of the fact that Republicans do not believe in the private sector and capitalism by the economy increasing, by it growing, by the GDP growing, by businesses growing, by employees growing, by people buying things and just the economy itself growing at large. They don't believe in it, so they have to put in their nice little safety net to set it up to fail, that they put in a stringent projection. And if they don't hit that projection, then we start going back to the way it was with tax increases. They were talking about repealing that amendment yesterday, which is what stalled the vote. Now, I hope they did. I don't know what the final bill is going to look like until afterwards. We have been encouraging individuals to call up Senator Jerry Moran's office because he is the one senator from Kansas. Pat Roberts seems to be on board. We heard his speech yesterday on C-SPAN on the Senate floor, encouraging, saying this is massively needed. This is extremely important. We need to do tax reform, and he's fully on board. Hat tip off to you, and congratulations, Senator Pat Roberts. Thank you for doing that. Senator Jerry Moran, not the same situation. I got messages on Facebook yesterday from three listeners that said I called Senator Jerry Moran's office, and first off, I was not very happy with my experience. They had tried to defend Senator Moran's indifference or concerns, let's put it that way, concerns about the tax bill, and because of that, right now, from what it sounded like, he is potentially voting no on this, which we cannot lose very many of them, by the way, remember. He's potentially voting no. I don't know what his mindset is right now. I can search social media here during the break and see. But potentially voting no because, well, Rand Paul included the repealing of the individual mandate from Obamacare in the tax bill. A tax bill cutting taxes, including the tax and punishment on you for not carrying health insurance, the individual mandate coverage, that is a tax that they tried to promise you was not a tax, but the Supreme Court told you it actually is a tax, and that's how it's actually somewhat constitutional, is included to be repealed. Getting rid of a tax burden. And Jerry Moran does not like that. He wants the individual mandate to stay in place. He wants the expansion of Medicaid to happen, and I'm very upset about that. I had three callers yesterday, three listeners, message me after the show. I called Senator Moran's office. That's the response that I got. I'm not very happy. I tried to call yesterday. After I heard these, about middle of the day, afternoon, I called one of his offices, the Wichita office, and I said, hey, first off, and I told him who I was. I said, this is Andy at KQAM Radio. And I said, first off, Where does he stand on this tax bill? What is he going to? How is he going to vote? And unfortunately, now again, I'm not knocking anybody in the offices. I'm not knocking the administration itself. It's been very, very frustrating, though, because I've had a show on the KQAM airwaves for 2.5 years now. I did the midday show until last November, and I've taken over the morning show now for over a year. For 2.5 years, there's been about 4 or 5 times that I've tried to reach out to his office and get him on this airwaves, get him on my program, get him on the show and talk about what he's doing. And every single time I get the exact same response, and yesterday was no difference. They're very nice. Oh, Andy, yeah, how you doing? Fantastic. All right, great. Let me send your information over to our communications office, and they'll reach out to you and set up a time to be able to talk and be able to get you in the information. And that's exactly what happened yesterday. I asked, first off, just the person that I answered. Very nice individual. But, hey, where does Jerry Moran stand on this tax issue? Well, I'm not sure. Let me send you over to the communications office. Or let me get your info, and they can call you. Okay. If it's going to be voted on this afternoon, can we get the senator on the airwaves tomorrow or early next week or sometime? I've never talked to the man. We have the only political talk show in the area. The other show is more, I mean, nothing against Stephen, Ted, and KNSS. I love those guys. They're fantastic. They're a great competitor. I like to be able to compete with them. They're not necessarily a talk show. They're a news show. The only talk show in the area that's local. And we want to know what's going on with our elected officials. Yes, he did a town hall meeting. Fantastic. Great. Come on the air and talk to us about what's going on. Okay, yeah, absolutely. We'll get your information. I'll send it over to the communications office, and they'll be able to reach out to you. Nothing. 4 or 5 times now over the last 2 years, I've tried this. Same response. No email, no phone call, nothing. So I don't know where he stands. I posted on the Facebook Live feed, on the KQAM Facebook Live feed, and on the Voice of Reason page where I shared the Facebook Live feed. I posted the office numbers for all of Jerry Moran's offices in Washington, D.C. and all over the state of Kansas. I posted the numbers. I will continue to try, and we may do something on the show that we've never done before the end of this hour, but I need you to call. I need you to encourage. The Democrats have done something huge. They have blasted it all over their Facebook. They blasted it and send out the blasts and the emails all over the state to encourage the Democrats to call Jerry Moran, because they know that he's the weak link here to be able to stop him from voting for this. They're not even trying to call Pat Roberts. They're focusing on Jerry Moran, and they've been calling in mass to encourage him not to vote for this tax reform. And the only way he's going to turn around and vote yes is if we show up in larger numbers with making phone calls, with making emails, with making our voice heard. That's the only way it's going to happen. The vote's going to happen in less than 2 hours from now, and we need to make sure that they hear us. So call now. Call now. I posted it on the Facebook Live feed, on the Voice Reason page, on the KQAM page, all over the Facebook Live. It's there. Look through the comments section, and the phone numbers are there. We need to make this voice heard. We need to allow him to know that we want him to vote yes on the tax reform. We still have a long ways to go. We're going to have to do this a couple of times, unfortunately, because number one, as soon as they do pass this, hopefully today, then it'll go to the subcommittee or the joint committee between the House and the Senate to combine the two tax bills from both chambers to blend the two together. And then they both have to vote on them again, which means not only do we have to call to make sure he supports this one, but the next one as well. It's important. It's essential. And we need to do it. Go on the Facebook Live feed right now. I posted the phone numbers for every one of his offices. Make the call. Back after this. This is The Voice of Reason on KQAM.
The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Be clear, by the way, the discussion about Senator Moran's office. First off, again, nothing against the office. They hand off the information to the communication side, and it's up to them to reach out. I got nothing against them in any way, shape, or form. It's just frustrating. We've had the show for 2.5 years, and we have not been able to get him on once. We're the only political talk show in the largest market in the largest city in the state of Kansas and the surrounding area here. It'd be kind of nice to be able to talk to our elected officials. That's all I'm saying. And I'll totally be nice with him. I may not agree with everything that he does, but let's talk. Just get the information out there. 721-8255-721-TALK. I encourage to call Senator Moran's offices, all of them. Pick up the phone. I'll call all 6-7 offices. Why not? Make your voice heard. Make them aware that we do want a tax reform. We do, along with that, by the way, want a repeal of that individual mandate, because that's what we just need to do. We have to do it. Have to do it. Message on Facebook as well. Isn't it just a rumor about Mike Pompeo moving to the Secretary of State position? Yes, it is. It is just a rumor as of right now. Nothing that I've seen has been concrete. However, more and more stories are popping up talking about it and discussing it. Now, Rex Tillerson said that he has not been aware or have been notified in any way, shape, or form that he would be removed from that position. So it is just a rumor. My comments, again, are just that if it does happen, that would be the best choice and probably the best transition that has happened in the office of the White House. And for some of those positions, it would be fantastic. He's got the inside scoop of what's happening from the CIA side. He's got the foreign relations side down pat. He is a hard worker. He's got the business-oriented mindset, the way he ran his office as a congressman, just like Donald Trump runs the White House and the country right now. He would be the absolute perfect match for that. He has been very loyal to President Trump. He's been very dedicated to President Trump, and I think he would be a solid fit. But yes, it is just a rumor right now. But just think about it. The potential of Kansas. We already have quite a reputation already with some of the positions that we have in the federal in the White House, in the Washington, D.C., at the federal level. We have been in the microscope and in the spotlight for the tax debate and the tax reform and the state of Kansas. And that's another reason why we need to call Pat Roberts, need to call Jerry Moran more so, and let them know. Because if we fail at the federal level, it's because the attack on Kansas has won. That would be the singular reason why we were not able to complete tax reform. The singular reason was because the attack on Kansas won, which means that our representatives... And well, our representatives did a great job from the House side. Our senators did not do a good job standing up and saying, I'm from Kansas. You got the story all wrong. And this is what's really happening. I never heard that from either one of them. When the state Democrats went to the Senate floor and discussed about the Kansas experiment, when the mainstream media in the Washington Post and the New York Times and every other news outlet and every other media on TV and on radio that was trying to criticize Kansas, no one stood up and defended Kansas. I did not see them say these Democrats are liars, they're manipulators, none of this actually happened. If you want to know the real story, then let's discuss the real story. We had a story from Alan Cobb write an opinion piece in USA Today. We had an editorial piece out of the Washington Times, New York Post, something like that, from Congressman Ron Estes being the treasurer. And you'd think that that would just blow up everywhere. Oh, yeah. During the time of the economic crisis happening in Kansas, the state treasurer at that time, now a congressman, knew exactly how he was writing the checks, knew exactly how he was paying the bills. Let's blow this up everywhere. But it was in one newspaper. No one talked about it except for here on The Voice of Reason. That's it. You would think he would be the one that everybody would flood to. Oh, hey, you were there. You were the state treasurer, for crying out loud, writing the checks for the state during this economic time. What really happened in your opinion? These Democrats are claiming this. You're nonpartisan-ish when it comes to the state treasurer position. What did you see? What happened? No one reached out to him. He had to do it himself, and it got published in one newspaper, and no one discussed it. They don't want to know the truth. They don't care about the truth. And if we fail on tax reform, it will be 90% of because that the Democrats in Kansas won by demonizing the Kansas experiment and conservative tax cuts here in the state of Kansas.
Time for Reason.
If this is a victory for Democrats thinking they have the momentum again, then let them have it. Because that's as far as they're going to go. In a state that was already won by Democrats, already predominantly blue, in a state where the Republican did not want to embrace current Republican trends. If you're not going to do that, then you're not going to win. End of story. It's very simple.
This is The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Welcome back into the Voice of Reason right here on the Big Talker KQAM. This portion of the Voice of Reason brought to you by Network Consultants, business owners. I know especially during the holidays, you're purchasing things that may be online. You're trying to get ready for 2018. Protect yourself from the hackers. Protect yourself from the computers crashing, dying, whatever the case is. Network Consultants can help you. They're an infrastructure company. They work majoritively with small to medium businesses. You that actually keep the economy running properly. They work on your firewalls and sonic walls, database safety and security, network communication, VPN, backup solutions, even getting you help helped getting set up onto the cloud in case your computer does crash and maybe you lose or you hurt your external hard drive. Whatever the case is, they can help you with all of it. When these things happen, whether it's the network where you're not communicating the way you need to, the printer that doesn't communicate with all the computers on the network, the program that you have that needs to run smoothly and efficiently for you to do the job appropriately and efficiently to be able to maximize your profits. When that stuff goes down, it's extremely expensive to repair. That's why you need to maintain it in the first place. And they can help you with that. Call them now. Tell them that I sent you and you'll get a free network analysis. Completely free. They'll come out to your business. They'll visit your business, review your system. They'll help you any way that you can if you have any issues, and then even help you guide to give you the tips and tools to fix things and maintain things yourself. Nobody else does that. They do have month-to-month plans available. You do not have to do any long-term agreements. All you have to do is give them a call, 316-201-4624, 316-201-4624, or visit them online at network-consultants.com. Again, network-consultants.com. Appreciate them partnering up with us here on The Voice of Reason. 721-8255-721-TALK. Let's go right to the phones here, shall we? Good morning. What's your name?
Hey, happy Friday.
Myron, how are you, sir?
I'm great.
Good.
Friday. Going to go see the governor.
It's a great
got
day.
Got to see a governor candidate last night. But, Andy, I can't believe you expect the Democrats to tell the truth.
I'd like for them to at least not lie to us to our Facebook like before. I mean, before what they used to do is they used to give us half-truths to where it was at least somewhat believable, and then they would manipulate us on the back end when we weren't looking. Nowadays, they literally get away with lying to us, bold-faced lies directly to our face, and they expect us to just walk along and believe it. It's a whole different world today than what it used to be.
Now, one of the things I noticed, and I hope this isn't one of those times, we will have one senator vote yes and one senator vote no. So it kind of wipes out whether the effectiveness of Kansas vote.
Right.
I would think both senators would be interested in what's best for Kansas. And I think best is to get rid of the individual mandate. That just really messes poor people up.
Sure.
And then we definitely need tax refund. I have to, again, disagree with some of their ideas, but some reform is better than no reform.
Exactly. We got to do something. And again, this is not going to be the final product. And Myron, I appreciate the call. It's not going to be, because once this one passes from the Senate, then we're going to go towards the joint committee from both chambers to be able to come up with the package together, because the House passed a bill too. And I think that one was almost better. So I want to see a better bill when it comes out in the end. They keep trying to fine tune it to make it perfect, and it's nowhere near perfect, but it's the best they can do with the small majority that they have of Republicans, and even Republicans not wanting to get on board. And if they don't support it for because of the purism of it and it's not good enough, or because they think it may harm whatever, I can see it. But what's more frustrating to me out of all of this is the fact that neither one of our senators, during the time that the Kansas Democrats went up there and tried to testify and talked about the failed Kansas experiment and how that has been the main focal point for Democrats to try and block this and stop this, and even moderate Republicans to try and woo over the moderate Republicans in the mainstream that do not like the tax reform that happened here in Kansas because we didn't compensate by spending, and that's been the talking point nationally to try and stop this, is that our Kansas senators did not stand up and defend their home state. They did not say, this is a bunch of BS, it's not true, it's a bunch of lies, this is what's really happening, and they didn't do that. One senator, one House member did that, and that was Congressman Ron Estes. And he did the best that he could, but no one even picked it up and tried to go towards him, being probably one of the most important figures of this by being the state treasurer of that time. But our state senators, or our U.S. senators from Kansas, heard about the attacks on Kansas, and instead of standing up and defending it, they said, yeah, that's why I'm cautious about doing this, because I don't want it to go the same way as Kansas. they fell into the same thing, and that's why I'm frustrated, more so than anything else. Even for a no vote on this, that's why I'm frustrated. 721-8255-721-TALK. Let's go to the phones here, shall we? Good morning. What's your name?
This is Michelle. Are you with me?
I'm with you, Michelle. How are you today?
I'm fine, and I'm calling to give phone numbers. Am I allowed to do that?
Please do. Absolutely.
Okay. It'll be nice and slow.
Okay.
But his Senator Moran's Wichita office, I mean, not Wichita, D.C., is 202-224-6521. His Manhattan office is 785-539-8973.
Mm-hmm.
And the Wichita office is 316-269-9257.
I'm glad you mentioned those. I did put those on the Facebook live feed. I understand a lot of people may not have Facebook or maybe not able to go on there. So I'm glad you mentioned those so that way we can call them. And I do want to run them by one more time. Again, the Wichita office, 316-269-9257. 9257 for that one. The D.C. office, 202-224-6521. Those are the really big ones. And then, of course, you can call the Hayes, the Manhattan, Pittsburgh, or Olathe offices as well. But I did put those on the Facebook live feed as well, but I am really glad you put those numbers out there because we need to call. We're less than an hour and a half away from that vote, and the more they hear from us, then hopefully that will encourage him enough to be able to vote yes on this bill.
Okay, well, I'll let you go.
Well, hey, I really appreciate that, Michelle. Thank you so much for that. 721-8255-721-TALK. Get out the vote. Make the call. Make sure he votes because that is what we do. As constituents, as activists, that's the only thing we can do is encourage him to do so. And again, the Democrats, they have done a fantastic job blasting out his numbers so that way the Democrats have been calling and encouraging him because they know that he's the weak link. They know that he's the wishy-washy potential no vote here that could block this. Senator McCain, for crying out loud, has even come out and supported this bill. And if John McCain's supporting it and our very own Senator Jerry Moran does not, I would be very concerned about that, wouldn't you? Let's go to the phone, shall we? Good morning. What's your name?
Hi, Andy. It's Pam.
Pam, how are you today?
Oh, pretty good. Another thing to add to those phone numbers.
Yes.
Don't bother to call anybody but the Washington office because they will not get the message in time.
Exactly, yes.
At all. And if you call Moran's Washington office, do not expect him to answer the phone. I have called numerous times over the years. I've got him to answer one time, and they hung up on me. So you can
leave a message, and I wouldn't anticipate him to answer the phone today anyways. I mean, it's almost an hour away from a debate and from the vote on the floor. He's probably at the floor right now, so I wouldn't anticipate him to answer the phone today anyways, but at least leave the message so they can tally who's actually calling and not calling. I tell you what, I've never done this before, and I don't know if it'll help us at all, but if I call Senator Moran's Washington, D.C. office live on the air right now, do you think that would do any good?
Oh, I think that would be fantastic.
Let's give it a try.
Now, whether it would do any good, I don't know.
Well, I'm sure they'll block me like they have before, but at least we can do it. And I will announce it that we're on the air. I've never done this before. I don't like doing it because I don't like catching people off guard in that sense. But it's important enough that I think we should try this.
And I don't really care. They, you know, the way they have treated constituents over the years, the best thing that could happen to us is get rid of the guy.
Well, so, I mean, we have until 2020 to make that happen. So if we're going to get someone to replace him, I guess they better start thinking about it now because we got a few years to be able to run against him.
I'm hopeful that we could get rid of them both. But,
sure. Well,
you know.
Well, we'll see. Pam, I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And I mean, if someone wants to run against them, I mean, that's a long ways off and they can start planning for that now. And I'm sure somebody is. Well, I've never done this before. Let's go ahead and try this and see how far we get. We're going to call live if you're watching Facebook Live, you see this is not recorded. This is not a joke. We'll call right now Senator Jerry Moran's office live in Washington, D.C. and see if we get anywhere. And see if we can at least let them know and see if we can get a gauge on what he's feeling as of this morning after the debates that happened last night. Let's see what we get. Will they answer? That's the question.
Hello, this is Jerry Moran. Thank you for taking the time to call.
I always appreciate hearing from Kansans.
Yeah, they didn't even answer. Go right to voicemail there. Hopefully that's because of the fact that so many people are calling right now. 721-8255-721-TALK. We may try again before the end of the show because it's that important. Let's take one more break. Wrapping up the show today. It's a free-for-all. It's an open line to you. I want to hear from you. This is The Voice of Reason on KQAM.
The Voice of Reason with Andy Hoosier.
Welcome back into The Voice of Reason, wrapping up the show today right here on KQA. Appreciate you hanging out with us. We'll try Senator Jerry Moran's Washington, D.C. office again here live on the radio in just a couple of minutes, see if we can get somebody as we're an hour away from that vote. But I do want to remind you, today's not just Friday or a free-for-all Friday, but today is also back at it today as a Fried Chicken Friday brought to you by the Inman Harvest Cafe. We love having those guys partner up with us here. 112 South Main Street in downtown Inman, just north of Hutchinson. They have their buffet from 11 to 1 today for the lunch, the big one from 5 to 8 o'clock this evening. And from another update, after a couple hours of waking up and getting prepared for this, Katie's back on the line with us. Katie, how are you today?
Good morning, Andy. Happy Fried Chicken Friday. I'm awake. Yeah.
Awake and making it happen. I was going to say, you guys have had an early morning getting all prepared for this big Fried Chicken Friday, as you usually do. And I love it because today is the big day you look forward to every single week. What do you got lined up for us?
Today, besides the fried chicken, the mashed potatoes, the vegetables, we've got a ham and scalloped potato casserole that's got saucy goodness with a breadcrumb topping. Then we're also going to have a chicken casserole, and that one has the chicken. It's got sage in it. It's got potatoes. It's really delicious. And then the other thing that we're going to have is kind of a it's almost a dessert type casserole. It's a sweet potato apple crumble, and it's got the sweet potatoes and the apples, it's got maple syrup in it, it's got this crumbly stuff on top that's got cinnamon and nutmeg. It's really, really delicious. The kitchen smells wonderful.
That sounds so delicious.
Yeah. Yeah, it's amazing. So then, and of course, all our food's made from scratch. All our food is, you know, we buy quality ingredients so that we can make our food from scratch, and it really drives my wholesale food distributor guy, the sales guy, it drives him crazy, because he's always trying to sell me, you know, like, oh, this is a great product, you can just, all you got to do is drop it in the, you know, you have this bag of this stuff, and you take it out of the freezer, and you drop it in the boiling water, and I'm like, Steve, it's called boiling bag, not cool. No.
You're like, no, sorry, that's just not the way we roll here. We make everything handmade.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah.
Well, and that's why there's not many places that do that anymore, and it's great, and that's why people love it so much. Now, again, you have the buffet from 11 to 1, the big one from 5 to 8 o'clock. You have the free slice of pie in the evening one as well. What do you have lined up for the pies today?
Hi, today we got coconut cream, we got chocolate heath. Pie, that's the chocolate pudding with little bits of Heath toffee in it, and then on top also. And then we've got sour cream raisin, custard, cherry cream, rhubarb, pumpkin pecan, which is like a blend of pecan and pumpkin pie together. And then we'll have a banana split this afternoon. So lots of choices, lots of different pies. If you get here and you don't see your favorite kind, I'm sorry, but there's lots to choose from, so you won't go hungry.
There's so many things happening up there. You guys put on this big, the big wild party every Friday. I love it.
Every Friday.
And I'm so glad, by the way, that you guys had last week off, the week prior to that, the biggest Thanksgiving Fried Chicken Friday you've ever had. I love it. It's fantastic. And the celebration needs to continue. It's Inman Harvest Cafe, 112 South Main Street in downtown Inman. Give them a call, 620-585-6925 or at InmanHarvestCafe.com. Katie, you guys enjoy Fried Chicken Friday. I love it. And we'll talk to you guys again next week.
All right. Sounds great. Thanks.
Always a pleasure there. That's Inman Harvest Cafe. Katie, we appreciate those guys partnering up with us here on The Voice of Reason. All right. We got some calls lined up, but I do want to try this. We got a few minutes left. Let's try and call one more time Senator Jerry Moran's Washington, D.C. offices. They are the closest to him, and they know hopefully the most of what's happening. I don't know whether we can get somebody or not. It was the voicemail last time, but we'll sure give it a try this time. Hopefully, they're just taking so many calls. And it helps if I don't call the fax number. That helps as well. Andy, don't call the fax line. Let's try this again. and see if we can get somebody for Senator Jerry Moran's office. Can we get
your call is very important to me, but I want to respect your time. Please leave me a message with questions, comments.
They have now forwarded it directly to voicemail. Didn't even ring once. It's now forwarded directly to voicemail, and if I'm sure that many people are getting that same message as well. Directly to voicemail. 7218255721 on talk. Leave a voicemail. Leave numerous voicemails. Let's go to the phones here, shall we? Good morning. What's your name?
It's Wallace.
Wallace, how are you, sir?
Doing well. Hey, I left my voicemail.
Good. So good.
I did. And, you know, I do. I get the same result. I call up there. I get a nice person that I'm sure scribbles something on a notepad and throws it in the trash can.
Mm-hmm.
But, hey, that aside, I don't. Did you see this this gal, since I'm going to call it Free for All Friday?
Yes.
She's running to be AG up in Michigan, and she says, want to end sexual harassment, vote for someone who doesn't have a penis.
I did see that, yes, because you know, nothing says equality and transparency and freedom and equality for everyone by saying if you have male parts, then just don't. You shouldn't vote for them in any way, shape, or form. You should only vote for women.
But what is she saying? She's bucking the whole Democrat agenda here by saying that a penis makes you a man. It's not gender neutral. It's not, you know, identity. You don't have
That's
a choice.
True. Someone could, I mean, they may still have one, but yet still claim that they are one because you can self-identify to whatever gender you want to. You're right. She is going against the entire agenda of what the progressives have been advocating for.
Matt Lauer and Harvey Weinstein need to come out and say, look, I have to admit, I identify as a woman, and mm-hmm. watch their heads explode. And they're going to be like, but you can't have a penis and have intercourse with a woman. Oh, it's a lesbian attraction.
Oh, well, yeah, and it's whatever kind of gender identification and then sexual orientation that they prefer. You're right. I think that maybe a Republican, just out of a satirical form, which I like to do, should announce a run against her as a male but claim to be a female and see how she responds to that. Because, you know what, they must accept that then. You're right. So
yeah, that's it. I mean, this is how liberalism just collapses in on itself, because, I mean, they come out and announce that a Viking that they found from thousands of years ago actually was a female Viking. How do they know that? They tested the DNA. DNA makes you a Viking. How do they know that wasn't a female Viking identifying as a man? They don't.
Yeah, see, this is the nonsense of the left.
Enjoy the weekend.
Well, Wallace, I appreciate the call. That's a great way to go out on a light light topic there. You're absolutely right. You know, hey, if you want to identify as something else, then you have the more power to do so. And just by making the claim, if you have male parts and you're not allowed to, you shouldn't vote for them in any way, shape, or form at all across the board. It kind of goes against their agenda of the identity politics that they like to play so much. She may not play into that progressive side of that identity politics, but welcome to the Democratic Party. Their ideas, their vision doesn't make any sense at all. You can beat it and break it down on the most basic levels, from the identity politics like Wallace just mentioned, all the way to serious issues like the taxes that we're debating right now. We are officially 1 hour away from the vote, and Senator Moran's office has gone directly to voicemail for the Washington, D.C. office. Now, I have heard that they've been doing that anytime after, like, the first hour that they open, which was this hour. So I'm surprised that we got the first ring, first three rings at the bottom of the hour when we tried this. But leave the voicemails. Even if they don't listen to your reasoning on why, hopefully they'll just at least keep tally. And as the Democrats have done such a major push on this, then we need to do that big push as well. One more time, that Washington, D.C. phone number is 202-224-6521. 202-224-6521. And then we can actually, hopefully, be able to rack up the numbers. Now, I did hear from a listener. They just posted on here. Sally on Facebook said that called the Wichita office. And as of from what they have heard, that he's likely to vote yes on the bill, but still up in the air an hour away from the vote, 2 hours away from the vote when they called. At least he's going to vote yes if that's the case. Now, whether I don't know what the final amendment looks like, I don't know what the bill actually looks like right now. Did they take out the structured safety net, quote unquote, that if we don't see projections of the economic growth and they start raising taxes again, did they take out the raising of the corporate tax rate from 20% that is proposed up to the 22-23%? I don't know what the final one will look like. I guess we'll find out after they vote on it today. But make those calls for the last hour. Blow up the phones, baby. That's what we're all about. This is your show. It's time to speak up, speak out, speak loud, speak proud, speak the truth, and always speak some reason. This is The Voice Reason on KQAM. Have a great weekend, everybody.